A Philippine congressional panel is set to investigate the government's alleged inaction over the landslide in Davao de Oro province last month. That tragedy killed 98 people. House Deputy Majority Leader Erwin Tulfo slammed the Environment Department and Maco Town officials for not enforcing the no-build zone order imposed in that landslide-hit area in 2008. Tulfo also accuses the local government of not preemptively evacuating the residents there. The lawmaker also believes the DNR should have filed charges against the Mines and Geosciences Bureau and local government officials.
They should have already filed charges. They should have already filed cases against the LGU, against the officials, the municipal planner, the mayor, the council, everybody. They should have already asked MGB how come the order was not implemented properly, or nobody followed that instruction or order that they gave in 2008. Dapat sila yung nanguna, sila yung spearheading this investigation. Dapat sila na nagkaso sa ombudsman. Kayo yung in charge there, Department of Environment and Natural Resources. This is environment, di ba? Natural resources. Bakit ayon yung kumilos? Bakit 98 ang patay, 98 died, and you don't want to move or lift a finger? What? Why wait for Congress? Hindi po namin trabaho mag-imbestiga. Our job in Congress and in Senate to pass laws, not to investigate primarily. Pero ganun na nangyayari because DNR doesn't want to move.
The Philippine Pole Body and a joint venture led by South Korean company Miro Systems ink a nearly 19 billion peso contract for an automated election system. Miro will be providing the hardware, software, and election management system for the 2025 midterm elections. Miro President Jin Bok-chung says they are committed to engaging in collaboration and dialogue to ensure the successful completion of the polls. Chung also urged the public not to be influenced by rumors of alleged irregularities of elections in other countries, such as the Congo and Iraq. The COMELEC is now bidding out the project for transmission and online voting. Agriculture Chief Francisco T. Laurel is back at the National Food Authority as concurrent administrator following the allegedly anomalous sale of rice buffer stocks. The Agri-Chief steps in as the ombudsman orders the suspension of two more executives of the food agency. So far, over 139 officials, including the NFA administrator, have been handed a preventive suspension. Laurel explains they want to stabilize the situation at the NFA and help employees continue to provide uninterrupted service, particularly this harvest season. Meantime, an audit is underway on the current rice stocks of the agency. The secretary says it will scrutinize data as far back as 2019. He wants to determine if there is a pattern to the agency's disadvantaged sale of rice buffer stocks. The NFA's mandate is to build a national rice buffer stock of 300,000 metric tons by buying rice from local farmers.
Filipino tourists get more flight options to one of travelers' preferred destinations. This comes as the Mactan Cebu International Airport is set to welcome daily flights from Tokyo's Narita International Airport offered by United Airlines. This service opens on July 31st of this year. But that's not all. United Airlines also provides convenient links to key U.S. destinations, including Los Angeles, San Francisco, and Houston. The partnership is also expected to benefit local tourist destinations.